Let's do this. On to the class trial. All rise.
Since this will be the final class trial, I've come up with a special rule. So listen up! If you can figure out Mukuro's killer and go on to solve the mystery of the
Mukuro's
school...
killer and go on to solve the mystery of the school...
You guys win! But if you can't...
Everyone's dead.
Then I win!
And Monokuma, I guess, will be considered the blackened.
And of course... Waiting for the loser is the super exciting, super hard pounding punishment!
Okay.
Are you saying that if you lose, you'll execute yourself?
Yep, sure will.
You, the Monokuma toy, or the headmaster, not the headmaster, the one controlling Monokuma?
And that's final? No loopholes? No wiggling out of it later?
Of course not! Bears never go back on their word!
Never mind all that. I just have one question for you.
Oh, you're taking this serious, huh? Are you feeling okay?
Is the mastermind only one person?
Hmm?
Don't bother. I already know the answer.
Oh. Is Yasuhiro being serious this time?
You're all the mastermind, aren't you? You're all out to get me!
This could be the case! I think he's serious in this one. He thinks that when whatever photo he got, he was the one that's out of it.
I'm right, aren't I? I knew it.
Okay, I'm not gonna say Yasuhiro's claim is stupid because, like, as stupid as Yasuhiro's acted in the previous before, I could definitely see his tense and emotion right now. Okay, let's do this. So he's not targeting me specific group photo. Places to check. Headmaster's e-handbook. Okay, the group photo has to be it. He was just fucking with us somehow.
You guys have all been working together, haven't you? I have evidence, so I know I'm right.
Okay.
Hey, you stole my line.
Really?
You're all out to get me. I'm sure of it.
Alright, so it has to be...
I have evidence of my own.
The group photo.
What a coincidence. I, too, have evidence to present. Evidence that proves everyone other than me has been working together.
Byakuya's in it too.
What? Wait, hold on. This doesn't make any sense. How can the three of us each have that kind of evidence?
Because...
No, it's wrong.
It's not just you three. I have evidence too.
Except I'm not saying all of you guys are the headmaster. I'm being... very well-minded here. The handmaster is just trying to fuck with our brains.
What? You too?
It's from the gym class, isn't it?
The evidence you're all referring to is this group photo, right?
Well, yeah. Huh? Wait, but mine's different.
I'm guessing yours didn't have yourself in it?
With the picture you have, I'm in it. But that can't be right. Because in my picture...
Oh, that's... different.
The only one not in
why the hell am I the one struggling in gym class? How am I... well, I'm not... how am I as equal as fucking... fuck, what's the fat guy's name again? Hifumi? How am I equal to Hifumi? What the fuck? Okay, this is interesting. It's also different photos, too, so... I figure as much, in which case...
Hiro, you have a picture too, right?
Let's see it.
Okay, but be careful with it. It's pretty important.
Okay. I'm guessing this one you see. Okay. Mondo's sleeping. What the fuck is Sakura doing to Fumi's hair? Of course, Aoi loves the donuts. Oh, guys. Genocide Jill is licking her. Okay. I see Leon try to photobomb.
So the secret in these pictures has been revealed.
Secret or whatever, I don't care. You guys are all in on this together. That's why I'm the only one missing.
Yeah, but you're in this on my photo and Aoi's photo. What about Byakuya?
But you're in my picture. You're the ones trying to trick me.
Oh, you two, can you guys be like simple-minded for once?
So the whole purpose behind these photos was to get us questioning and fighting with each other. The mastermind laid a trap to make us each think everyone else was working against us.
Huh? I laid a trap? A trap? How rude! What grounds evidence do you have for such audacious accusations?
The proof I need to review Monokuma's trap. Each photo has a certain something in common. There's a connection regarding what person isn't shown in the group photos. Monokuma, Toko, the ones who got the photos. Okay, there's a time limit here, so... But then again, I could easily pause that just by doing that, right? So, I could basically just time the thing out, so... Our choices are Monokuma, Toko, for some reason. And the ones who got the photo... It can't be Toko... Wait, I didn't really pay attention to Toko at all. Okay, so... Wait, from what I remember, Toko in my photo was Toko. Toko in Yasuhiro's photo was Genocide Jill. I forgot... I didn't pay attention to Aoi's photo at all, so I didn't know where Toko was. I was kind of paying more attention to how Sakura was, like, fucking rushing it, like, hell. So, I doubt Toko is the case. What's this? Wait, and that person is... Hold on, can I... I can't press square or triangle or select, so I can't look at the previous one. Monokuma's the only one that... Sure, why the fuck not? I don't know. Well, you guys were having so much fun frolicking together, I was out catching salmon for the winter. That's all there is to it. Ignoring what he said, how is Monokuma not being in the pictures a trap? Okay, so we're trying to figure out how they're a trap or whatever. Wait a minute, Toko's the only one that didn't get... He's not a student here, okay.
Shoot.
Okay, looks embarrassing to everyone, okay. Something in common. The ones who got the photos. Oh, why not?
I got it.
Okay.
In each case, the only one not in the picture is the person who received it.
In each case, the person, the only person, okay.
So, in the picture I got, I'm the only one missing. In the picture Hina got, she's the only one missing.
Okay, so Toko is still Toko. Okay. Is that like standard gym uniform for girls? Because, I don't know, that kind of seems very sexualized in my opinion.
And in the picture Hiro got, he's the only one missing.
Alright, what about you, Byakuya? You said something too.
As long as we're talking about it, I suppose I should show you my photo as well.
Okay. Ooh, la la!
In other words, Monokuma gave each of us a group photo in which that person wasn't included.
And when we each saw her picture, we just assumed everyone else was the enemy?
Figured it out, huh?
Yeah, I thought that must be it. But how was that a hint?
A hint. But you know, there might be more to this than just Monokuma trying to confuse us. Kyoko, I don't think you got the photo, did you? The same thing goes for Toko, I'm guessing. There's something else that bothers me about everyone's pictures. What is it? What's digging at me?
Listen, can I see everyone's group photo one more time? It's not directly connected to what we're talking about, but I'd like to double check something.
Sure, no problem.
Yeah, I don't mind.
I'm sure there's something unusual about these group photos. What is it? I need to compare each of them one more time. Alright, let's look at all these. Alright, can I... Alright, Byakuya's picture. Let me see everything. Toko is... I don't know. Toko and Celeste, for some reason, keep on having the same uniforms. Or the same... clothes. I'm guessing. Sakura doing the shuriken on Ifumi. Poor Ifumi. What has he ever done? Mercuro... I was about to say Mercuro is also flies in the same line as well, but it looks like Mercuro is topless. I always like the lifeguard, that's fun. What the hell am I doing? Am I sticking out my tongue? Alright, there's Kyoko and blue hair chick, I forgot what her name was. Sakura, I think? No, Sakura was that. Was the tough, meaty, buff girl. I forgot who the blue hair girl was. Okay. So this is Byakuya's picture. I'm trying to, like, see if there's any connection. Okay. Celeste also is on the same stance. Toko's in a different one this time, but... Mercuro this time is in, a uniform, I guess. Hina's picture. Celeste, I don't know why I'm pinpointing Celeste specifically, but she seems to be in the same exact pose, same exact outfit for every time. Mercuros looks like she might still be wearing the same outfit, but at the same time, it looks more like a school uniform, if anything. I can't really say much about Leon because he's actually, I don't know, I guess he's being rebellious, but at the same time, he's at least doing some sort of different commands. Celeste is something I'm kind of more suspicious about. I'm noticing, like, Sakura and Hifumi are, like, kind of, like, buddy-buddies, or at the same time, Hifumi's, like, fucking scared of Sakura or something, I don't know. Alright, Toko is Genocide Jack, or Genocide Jill, and whose photo is this? This is Yasuhiro's, because Yasuhiro's not in it. Junko? I can't really say much about Junko, it doesn't look like she's suspicious. Celeste, again, she's in the same pose, that has to be it! Okay. There's something strange about all of them, something I can't quite pin down. Something. Alright, group photo. We can see each group photo, right? Just to review, just in case. Hold on. We can't see each other's group photos? Aw, damn. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna remember about Celeste's, Celeste's position for later.
Trying to trick me with such an obviously fake photo? I'm still pissed about that.
And on top of that, they went to all that trouble to make it look like we were wearing matching uniforms.
Hmm? So you think they're fake?
I forgot to put the stopwatch again. I apologize.
No, no, no. I assure you, they're quite real.
Are we in the fucking Matrix or something?
What are you talking about? There's no way.
Yeah. I don't remember ever taking a picture like that.
Although at the same time, I doubt that you remember this notebook that I have with you right now. The same thing goes for Kyoko, which I can attest to, saying she doesn't remember having another notebook that she wrote. So, our memory was just wiped, probably. We probably did have some sort of, like, connection to each other beforehand, and our memory is just completely wiped.
So it's gotta be a fake.
This might be before whatever happened to our memories got wiped out, so we probably had a good time, be buddy-buddies and all that shit. But somehow, like, whoever Monokuma's is...
No, can we really be so sure?
Huh?
Don't get me wrong, I don't remember taking this picture either. But is that really enough to be absolutely positive they're fake?
What do you mean?
The reason I don't remember this picture isn't necessarily because it's fake. There might be some other reason. Some terrible reason. An unbelievable but entirely horrifying reason. Amnesia, maybe? Lost memories? Hangman's Gambit. Oh, come on. Doing this shit again? Alright. A and amnesia. Well, that's easy. I just had to remember how to spell amnesia, so I'm guessing there's an E somewhere. Amnesia. N. Where's the N? N. Where the fuck's the end? Come on, hurry up! I don't have all the time in the world, you know? I-A-S-R... Where the fuck's N? Can I slow down? I can, but, like, there's no point if the N won't show up. What? Okay, it's S. I thought for some reason, like, I had the N already, but... Okay, amnesia. So now I need the A. There you are. Perfect. That's really the only explanation I could figure it out. Amnesia. All of us have it somehow.
Let's say that somehow, we'd all lost our memories. That could explain it, couldn't it?
And I probably have proof too, with this DVD that I got.
Oh, I get it. So we all just lost our memories at the same time, and forgot about the photo. Makes sense. As if. You expect me to believe such an unbelievable occult-type story?
Should I present the fucking... Should I have, like, a DVR player or something?
Yeah. We all lost our memories? That's just... crazy!
It's only natural that they wouldn't believe it. Okay, so how do you remember getting into this school then? But no matter how much they refuse, if that's the absolute truth, they have no choice. We can't move forward until they accept it. There's another way to prove it besides those pictures. Give me the DVR player! Alright. Where is it? I know the answer already. Welcome. Interview DVD. They're awfully giving us a lot of goddamn evidence when it's so obviously the interview DVD that could showcase.
You're saying we all got spontaneous amnesia? Since when did this turn into some kind of sci-fi fantasy?
I promise you, I haven't lost my memory. Ever since I got to this school,
oh,
I remember everything that's happened.
Okay.
So the idea that we all lost our
memory. Alright, that has to be it.
This is totally stupid.
Obviously.
Okay, this is easy.
You're saying we all got... Since when did this turn into some...
I promise you, ever since I got to this school, I remember everything that's happened.
Fuck you, there's no way, look... Oh my god.
Okay. Totally stupid, obviously.
So that thing's blocking the way.
You're saying we all got... Since when did this turn into some...
I promise you, ever since I got to this school, I remember everything that's happened.
Oh! Shot the wrong thing! Okay.
Totally stupid, obviously.
Sorry, Dynamic Compression.
You're saying
okay. There we go. Jesus Christ, that took way longer than it needed to take. Alright. Here's the interview DVD.
Those photos aren't the only things that point to the possibility of memory loss. This DVD does the same thing.
You're gonna show us something indecent, are you?
Oh, I wish.
No, it's nothing like that. It's a video of all of us being interviewed by the Hope's Peak Academy headmaster.
When you say all of us, you mean...
I mean all of us, including you.
You lie! I never did any kind of interview.
No, it's not a lie. Just watch the DVD and you'll see for yourself.
Can we, though? Yeah, there's a DVR player behind us, so...
The headmaster did, in fact, interview you.
I didn't imagine you would remember.
It's not about whether or not I remember. You expect me to believe all this? That I lost my memory somehow?
Well, we don't have any way to refute it, so we have no choice but to accept it as reality.
Hey, at least Miyakiya's alongside with me.
Don't you say that? We're talking about living, breathing amnesia here.
To be honest, I have something else on my mind right now.
Something else?
You said the DVD contains recordings of us being interviewed by the headmaster, right? What were the interviews about?
About accepting our lives in here, apparently?
The headmaster sat each of us down, one at a time, and asked us the same question. He asked us if we could accept the idea of spending the rest of our lives in this school.
What kind of question is that?
And how did we answer?
We all answered yes.
We'd say no, obviously.
Actually, we all said we could. Even me, I heard myself say yes. I could spend the rest of my life at this school.
Why? Why would you say yes to something like that?
I don't know. I don't remember a thing.
The same goes for everyone else. Nobody remembers. You don't remember choosing to live here forever. Or even talking to the headmaster about it at all.
It doesn't matter if I remember or not. Even if I bought the whole amnesia thing, the idea that I would want to live here forever? That's just insane! How can I believe that?
Insane or not, we can't move forward until you accept it. Am I right?
That is true.
You sure are, cause it's all
okay, Monokuma, can you please shut the fuck up? You're not helping their cause. We're just gonna be in a la- I see that. What? That's what you're trying to do here, okay!
I know it sounds absurd, but if it's the truth, there's nothing we can do about it.
Indeed. We only have one path in front of us.
Then, I really...
Yep. You all totally lost your memory at the same time.
This is all making my head hurt.
And this isn't like some normal kind of memory loss. You stole those specific memories from us.
Stole specific memories? That's a huge claim. I didn't actually think about that now that I think about it.
You figured that part out too.
Oh yeah, that makes sense with the photos and all that, so.
There's no way we would all just happen to get amnesia at the same time.
Exactly.
How could someone just steal our memories?
How? Come, come, come. That hardly matters right now. If I said it was was hypnotism, would you believe me? Or we opened up your skulls and messed with your brains? Would you really believe anything I said? How it happened doesn't matter right now.
What matters is figuring out what memories you took from us. That's what you're trying to say, right?
I knew I could count on you!
The interview with the headmaster, taking that group photo, those can't be the only memories we lost. There must have been a purpose to it all. A reason for taking away our memories.
Of course there was a purpose. It all has to do with the original motive!
Showing us, showcasing us with the spare, killing each other, and filming it in front of a live studio audience, I'm guessing, for entertainment.
You mean the motive you came up with to try and get us to all kill each other?
That has something to do with the memories you stole from us?
Of course, because I'm guessing if that's the case, then we would never be able to kill each other if we're all goody-two-shoes and friends, right? So, that has to be the case.
It sure does. But that part's still a secret. Anyway,
okay.
Sure it's not easy, but let's all focus on the class trial for the murder of Mokuro Ikusaba.
Okay, so you want us to figure out who killed her before we do anything else.
So until we do that... Well, either way, we have to explain every last remaining mystery. So, the one who killed Mokuro, the true mastermind, that's what we have to expose. Okay. Okay. What's our pile of arguments right now? Control room, Mokuro's profile, headmaster's e-handbook. Let's try Iku. That seems to be the only one that's relating to...
So who did it?
Okay.
Who killed her?
Whoever did it is the same one who's behind everything. That much I'm sure of.
Okay.
When you think about it, is the mastermind really here in the school?
Yes.
Of course. They have to be here somewhere.
Alright, I'm green to her, so I can't speak with that.
What does make me so sure?
The control room?
Exactly. You're just making stuff up. There's no way.
Okay, never mind. I guess it's Monokuma's control room then.
The mastermind is probably a million miles away.
Okay. Never mind. Okay. We know. We are. They're somewhere in this school. They're in the control panel room. That's how they're controlling Monokuma right now. I'm surprised how I always still forget it, though.
You're just making stuff up. There's no way the mastermind is. The mastermind is probably a million.
Bam. Alright. I'm surprised I'm remembering everything from this trial. Alright.
There's no question that the mastermind is somewhere within the school.
How do you know? Did you find some evidence or something?
Well, thanks for spoiling the fun, Toko. Yes, I do have evidence, in fact.
In the back of the data center, I found a panel that controls Monokuma. The mastermind must have been using that to control it all this time.
Yeah, oh, you are really forgetful sometimes. I'm sorry.
So there can't be any doubt. The mastermind has been inside the school all along.
And if we know how to somehow bust a fucking door open, then we know the mastermind right now is in Monokuma's room right now,
there
controlling him.
Be any doubt. In which case, there also can be no doubt that the mastermind is one of us.
Really now, Byakuya?
What? Why?
Recall what Makoto told us Monokuma said to him earlier.
I'm sure I told you this already, but this killing game began with 16 participants, all of them high school students, and the only people to take a single step in the Hope Speak Academy since the killing game began are those 16 students.
So if the mastermind is in the school, we have to assume it can only be that 16th student.
But how'd they manage to survive all of this?
So we're the
only Are we talking about the mastermind of the killing game or the mastermind of this school exactly, Byakuya?
It's not me. I'm not the mastermind.
Well, it's not me. I blame Makoto.
Why the fuck, you bitch?
What? Why me?
Exactly.
Because it's super weird how you're the only one who survived being executed.
Well, you should thank fucking Chihiro for that.
Oh, I get it. The only way he could have survived is if he was actually the mastermind himself.
Okay,
right?
Now I'm... Okay.
Aw, nuts! You got me!
You are are so dead, you stupid fucking bear.
Wait! What are you trying to say?
Everyone, calm down. There's no reason to panic.
Thanks, Kyoko. Jesus Christ.
The Mastermind's true identity will become clear soon enough. Just as soon as we find out who killed Mukuro.
That's a good point. Rather than wasting time bickering...
Thanks, Byakuya, despite the fact that you had to mention this in the first place. But whatever.
How much time have we already spent talking about the murder?
He's right. What more is there to talk about?
If you want something to talk about, I think there might be one thing. We haven't fully established what Mukuro's fatal injury was.
True.
Huh? But I thought we figured that out. She died when she got hit in the back of the head.
No, that isn't actually what killed her. It was something entirely different. Wouldn't you agree, Makoto?
Mukuro's actual cause of death must have been... Fuck. I can't review my evidence, so... I have a 33% chance. A blow to a head, we already established that it can't be that. The other wounds? That could be it.
I got it!
Because she had other scars beforehand, too, so...
covering her body. That's what really killed her.
The dead body has to be several days old, I'm guessing.
Hey, now hold on a second. You did read the Monokuma file, right?
The body was covered with other wounds, but these were at least several days old. So my thesis is that she died several days ago.
It made it pretty clear. Those wounds were made at least a few days ago. So they can't possibly be what killed her.
Consider this. What if the murder itself took place at least a few days ago?
What?
What if, when we discovered her body, she'd already been dead for several days? If that's true, then naturally the wounds that killed her would appear to be however many days old.
That doesn't make any sense. Because she had all those wounds before she ever came here.
Nope. That's also established that those wounds happened to happen during the school, not before she got here.
Isn't it obvious? She was the ultimate soldier, right? So that means... you know...
You're wrong.
She denied me. Before I could even say anything.
Okay, Toko, stop getting your orgasms, please.
I'm not weird, okay? Listen to what I have to say.
Is Toko a possible lesbian? Because... I don't know, she seems to be having a thing for Kyoko now. If you're so sure we're gonna deny you, why bother saying it in the first place? Okay. So it has to be the fact that she examined... Or was it? Group photo interview, Makuro's profile. Headmaster's e-handbook, Mokuro's control... What was this? Okay. Profile.
Mukuro was the ultimate soldier.
Oops, shit, wrong one. No, that's not it.
You must have been in 100 different battles. So,
whatever.
Think about it. Obviously, she got all of those wounds in battle.
God damn it, why is this spinning? Are you finished?
You didn't deny me this time. You made me go all cutesy.
That wasn't really cute, though.
There wasn't anything cute about it.
Exactly, Yasuhiro. High five, buddy! Self high five. I'm so lonely. No, those wounds didn't come from the battlefield. One look at what was written about her, that should be clear. Okay, well, thanks for giving me the answer, game! Oops, goddammit.
She must have been in 100 different battles. So, when you think about it, obviously, she got all those wounds in battle.
There we go. I really had to waste my slowdown, but whatever.
No. Mukuro didn't suffer those wounds in battle. The file we found in the headmaster's room said as much. Despite the time she spent in battle after battle as a member of Fenrir, when she entered this school, she hadn't sustained a single injury.
Ooh. What do you say about that?
So completely. Actually, it's kind of refreshing. Maybe it's because of all of Master's training.
Are you saying that Byakuya is always wrong? Okay.
So we can be sure that Mukuro suffered all those wounds after coming to this school, in which case, they could be the very thing that killed her.
As a matter of fact, it's hard to imagine any other possibility. When examining her body, I found that her stomach and head wounds came after she was already dead.
Unless anyone has any better suggestions, I think we can say this with confidence. The wounds Mukuro sustained all over her body are what ultimately killed her.
Is that really Mukuro's body? She doesn't look like that. She's that big-chested.
But if that's what killed her...
Okay, so whatever. If that's Kuoko Mukuro's body, then I guess that is Junko, then.
Then does that mean she's really been dead for who knows how long?
That's exactly what it means. When we found her body in the garden, she'd already been dead for several days.
So then, what about the little matter of what happened last night? Makoto, you said you were attacked in your room by a masked assailant. If Mukuro had already been dead for several days, certainly it couldn't have been her. So who was it that attacked you?
The identity of the one who attacked me. I can't think of anyone else. Mukuro. It can't be Mukuro. The mastermind? No, he's dead. So it has to be the... Well, no, the headmaster. No, the headmaster is... Kyoko's... Okay, I'm sorry, I'm mixing the two words up. It has to be the mastermind, then. That's the only explanation.
Was the true mastermind. When we discovered Mukuro in the garden wearing the same mask, I naturally assumed she must have been the one who attacked me. But I was wrong. It wasn't her at all. It was the mastermind.
What are you laughing at? Oh, don't mind me. I'm just getting a little impatient sitting here listening. I think I'm gonna jump.
All right, what's your testimony, sir?
Let's start off with a nice, easy question. Your assumption that I attacked Makoto is just that, right? An assumption.
Not Monokuma the bear, but the mastermind controlling you.
You can't really know who was under that mask, can you? I mean, that's the whole point of a mask. The true identity of the masked attacker is Mukuro Ikusaba. At least, that's what I think. Do you have any evidence that might convince me otherwise?
No, there's no way Mukuro is the one that attacked me. Even if I didn't see their face. Body proportions. She had no tits. Even though in the profile, she also looked like she had no tits. I'm just gonna go up by that. Mukuro had a very obvious Fenrir tattoo comparing to the masked attacker. Wow, you were able to remember that detail. Yeah, on the right hand, wasn't there? It should be obvious. Wait, am I testifying or am I trying to dispute Makoto? Oh, sorry, not Makoto. Monokuma. Okay, there's only one file this time. So this should be pretty straightforward, right? Unless I had to add multiple.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who was under that mask. I'm telling you now, it was Mukuro Ikusaba!
Yeah, it can't be Mukuro, so it doesn't say anything about tattoo.
Even without seeing their face, there's another part of the attacker we can use to prove it wasn't.
Was it holding triangle, right?
Oh? This other part. Is it the right hand?
Bam, bitch!
The left hand?
Bitch!
Maybe the right foot.
Really?
Or perhaps the left foot.
Thanks for giving us all these pointless details.
The hips.
Her most noticeable feature, the tattoo that marked her Fenrir. Can I check the... Okay, I just want to be just in case. It is on her right hand, correct? Before then, that's an addition for course of the characteristics. Not have a scar wound. Where's this Fenrir tattoo though? Specifically. Fatal injury. Attest that both stab wounds and blood to the head were inflicted after death. Okay. No, that's not it either. Did it say where? What her. Okay. Wow, this is probably gonna be in the end of the evidence or something. Doesn't say anything about her. Okay, it has to be her right hand, right? Is that this one? Not a single stab wound to the body. Struck. Dead. doesn't say anything. I guess we just have to remember it from memory. Fuck, I'm just gonna go for the right hand from what I remember. It's either right hand or left hand. It can't be her foot or her hips, so... easy spot area. Okay.
You never saw their face, right? So you can't have any idea who I'm telling you now. It was Mukuro.
No. Bam, bitch! Take that!
Mukuro had a tattoo on her right hand, if I remember correctly.
We're right back with the next episode, and we're gonna continue on with this discussion of Mukuro, whether or not she's the killer or not. Stay tuned.